Hello children, welcome to the class. Children, today we have taken a interesting poem. Okay, this poem is related to the nature. Okay, what is the poem name? Our poem name is Sonnet and it is written by Thorudhar. Okay, an English writer, author, novelist. She's everything, poetess. Okay, so Sonnet. Have you heard about Sonnet, children? What do you mean by Sonnet? Sonnet is a way of writing poem. Okay, so this way of writing is inculcated by many of them. William Shakespeare have used this sonnet style, and William Wordsworth and many of the great literary persons have used this way of writing sonnet. Okay, this way of writing poet. Sorry, this way of writing poem. Okay, so here our poet poetess also has used a sonnet in writing the poem. Now what do you mean by sonnet? Sonnet is a poem which has only one paragraph, single paragraph, and it includes 14 lines. Okay children, the sonnet is a type of writing poet, an art of writing poem. Okay, so here the poem is divided, or it has only one paragraph and the lines will be 14 lines. It will be having only 14 lines, and these 14 lines will be divided into 4 lines each and last 2 lines. Okay, like this example. First 4 lines, second 4 lines, third 4 lines, and last 2 lines. Children, these 4 lines, these 4 lines are known as quatrains. These 4 lines are called quatrains, and the last 2 lines are known as couplets. The last 2 lines are known as couplets. These 4 lines. 4 lines is also known as quatrains, and these 4 lines are also known as quatrains. Okay, because it is divided into 4 lines each. Okay, and the special thing is what we can say is the rhyming words. Okay, the rhyming scheme in the sonnet is like: first line is related to fourth line, and second line rhyming word is related to third line. Like wise, like AB in the form of AB, AB. Okay, and next line will be CD, CD. And next will be EF and EF. And last 2 lines rhyming scheme is known as G and G. Okay, did you understand children? See here, A, B and A, B. This is in English literature. The rhyming word will be divided into A, B and A, B. Means first line of the last word is related or rhymed with the fourth line last word. And the second line last word rhyme is related to the third line last word. For example, see round, abound. Then green, seen. Did you understand children? The rhyming word is, the scheme is divided into A, B and A, B. Okay. Now, here what the author is telling here, the full 12 lines here in the sonnet, the full 12 lines that is divided into, which is divided into 4 each, these 12 lines will give you a description. Okay, description of the poem, what the poem is about, and the last 2 lines will give you the conclusion. Okay, what is the poem all about? Okay, what does the poem tell us? Okay, the first 12 lines will give you just the description. Okay, and the last 2 lines will give you the conclusion of the poem. Did you understand children? So, sonnet is a way of writing poem. It is one of the way of writing poem in which the sonnet will be having one para, okay, and that para will be divided in, sorry, that para will include 14 lines. Okay, sonnet is one para poem which includes, or which will be having, or which will have 14 lines. And that 14 lines will be divided into 4 lines each and last 2 lines. Okay, that 4 lines are known as quatrains, and last 2 lines are known as couplets. Okay, now the first 12 lines will give you the description of the poem. It tells what the poem is telling us. Okay, and last 2 lines will give us the conclusion. Okay, so, and this poem is written by Torudhar. Okay, did you understand, children? Okay, now we'll move on to the poet and we'll see who is poet, what she did, what are her works, we will see. Okay, children, now we will know about our poet. Okay, our poet, what is the poet name? Our poet name is Torudhar. Okay, she was born on March 4th in the year 1856 in Kolkata city. When she was born? She was born on March 4th in the year 1856 in Kolkata city, and nationality she was Indian, and later her family converted into Christianity. Now languages, in which all the languages she has written her works, or she has written the books in the languages of Bengali, English, French and Sanskrit. In these languages she has done her prominent work, literary work. Now her works, which are her famous works? Her famous works are The Unfinished Bianca and Ancient Ballads and Legends of Hindustan, Lotus, Sita. These are her few famous works, famous poets. Oh, sorry. These are her famous poems, poem collections. Okay. The Unfinished Bianca, Ancient Ballads and Legends of Hindustan. And these are her novels, and Lotus and Sita. These are her poems. Okay, so she has done a prominent work in the languages of Bengali, English, French and Sanskrit. And when she was died on August 30th in the year 1877. She was died on August 30th, 1877. And she lost her life at a very young age. At the age of 23, she passed away. Okay, but in her short life, she has done so many prominent works in different languages. She was a famous writer, famous author, famous novelist. Okay, she was also a translator. Many of her books she herself translated into the different languages. Did you understand, children, about the poet? Okay, now we'll move on to our poem. Okay, our poem is about sonnet. Okay, this is sonnet. As I told you earlier, it is a poem which has only 14 lines. Here in this poem, Torudhar describes the beauty of her garden around her bungalow. Okay, she will say that her garden is very beautiful, and she compares the garden, her garden, to a sea foliage. Okay, but she also tells us that we should not come to a conclusion that sea will be having only one color. But here she tells her that her garden is very vast, very big like sea, but it is not monotonous like sea, the color of the sea. Her garden will be having different contrasts of colors. Okay, and she also tells that she has different kinds of trees in her garden, and if someone look at her garden, they will be very amazed. Okay, they will be very amazed. And she also describes that her garden was the earliest garden which was created by God for Adam and Eve. Do you know who is Adam and Eve? Adam and Eve were the first humans who lived on the earth. So here the poet compares her garden to the ancient time, and she tells us her garden was created by God where Adam and Eve were living. Okay, understood, children? Now we'll move on to our poem. A sea of foliage grids our garden round, but not a sea of dull, unvaried green. Sharp contrasts of all colors here are seen. The light green, graceful tamarinds abound. Amid the mango clumps of green profound, and palms arise like pillars gray, between and over the quiet pools the sea mules lain. Red and startling like a trumpet's sound, but nothing can be lovelier than the ranges of bamboos to the eastward. When the moon looks through their gaps and the white lotus changes into a cup of silver, one might swoon drunken with beauty, then or gaze and gaze on a primeval Eden in amaze. You understand? Okay, one more time I'll read up. A sea of foliage grids our garden round, but not a sea of dull, unvaried green. Sharp contrast of all colors here are seen. The light green graceful tamarinds abound amid the mango clumps of green profound, and palms arise like pillars gray between and over the quiet pools the sea mews lane. Red, red and startling like a trumpet's sound, but nothing can be lovelier than the ranges of bamboos to the eastward when the moon looks through their gaps, and the white lotus changes into a cup of silver one might swoon drunken with beauty, then our gaze and gaze unimpermeable, hidden in amaze. Here what the poet is describing? Here the poet describes the beauty of the garden around her bungalow, and she tells her that her garden appeared like a sea of foliage. Here what do you mean by foliage? Foliage means leaves. She tells us that her garden is covered, is surrounded by leaves, okay, thick leaves. But she advises, and she also advises that we should not come to a hasty conclusion. Means we should not come to a quick conclusion that her garden is only with a dull color, because she is having only one color, monotonous color, that is green or blue color. And she tells us that we should not come to a conclusion that her garden is monotonous. Okay. She tells us that her garden is covered with or surrounded with lot of colors. Here she will give the contrast. She will give the contrast colors. She tells us that my garden is not like the sea of unvaried green. Okay. She tells us that my garden is not only green color. Okay, with green, along with green color, I have different shades of green color in my garden. Okay, now she also tells us that she has like light green color, dark green. Okay, and she also tells us that the tamarinds abound amid the mango clumps of green profound. Here what the author is telling, the poet is telling that you can see the light green colors and dark green colors among the tamarinds and the mango tree groups. Now, the palm arise like pillars gray between and over the quiet pools, the sea mews lane. Here what the poet is telling, in between the mango trees and tamarind trees, the palm trees arises. How they arises? How they look like? The palm trees arises between tamarind trees and mango trees, and they look like gray pillars. Which color she is giving here? Gray color, gray pillars. And the sea mule trees. What do you mean by sea mule? Here, sea mule means silk cotton tree. This is a kind of tree, okay, which will be having maroon flower. So here also she has described the other color, that is maroon color. Okay. Now what the poet is telling, in between tamarind and mango clumps, okay, and she tells us that the palm trees arises. The palm trees grow like gray pillars, and the sea mule trees, the sea mules tree, they will lean over the ponds in the garden. What the poet is telling? The poet is telling that the palm trees and the sea mule trees, they look like the gray pillars, and the sea mule trees are leaning over the pond. Okay. Now, they all are red in color. They all are red in color, and they give a wondering, they are giving the amazing sound. The trees, the palm trees, mango trees, tamarind trees, and the sea mule trees, what they are doing? They are giving the amazing sound, which sounds like the trumpet sound. Trumpet is a, means it is a device, okay, music device. So the poet is telling that in between the tamarind trees, as I told earlier, in between tamarind and mango trees, the palm trees arises like a gray pillars, and the sea mule trees, which has maroon flower, they will be leaned on the pond in the garden, and they give the sound like the trumpet sound, a pleasant sound. Now, in the next para, but nothing can be lovelier than the ranges of bamboos to the eastward when the moon looks through their gaps. Here what the poet is telling, in these lines the poet is telling that she is enchanted, she is surprised. She is happy by the bamboo trees, okay, which is grown in the east side of her garden. Now the poet is telling that, she tells that there is no other garden which is lovelier than the garden of the bamboos. Okay, ranges means like mountains. It has grown into a ranges, and she tells us that what the bamboo ranges are the lovelier ranges, are the loveliest ranges. And she also tells us that the moon peeps, when the moon peeps through the gaps, okay, when the moon peeps through the gaps of the trees, the lotus, what happens? The white lotus changes into a cup of silver. Here what the poet is telling? The poet is telling that when the moonlight passes through the gaps of the trees, the lotus, the white lotus will turn into a silver cup. The picture of the lotus, white lotus, will resemble like a silver cup. Okay, did you understand, children? Yes. Now next, one might swoon drunken with beauty then, or gaze on a primeval Eden in amaze. Here what the poet is telling? In the last three lines, the poet describes that, okay, the beauty of the garden was so amazing, was so enchanting, that one can enjoy the beauty of the garden and they will be amazed. Means here swoon, they will be swooned. Means here, what do you mean by swoon? Swoon means feeling dizzy. The people, whoever looks at her garden, they will feel dizzy. Okay, because of the beauty of her garden. And she will say that her garden was a primitive garden. Okay, her garden was an ancient garden. Primitive means, or primeval means here ancient, or the earliest. Okay, her garden is the earliest garden which is created by the God. Okay, which is created by the God for Adam and Eve to live. Okay, Adam and Eve are the first human beings who lived on the earth. So yeah, the poet is telling that her garden is very beautiful. So if they see her garden, they will be dizzy and they will understand that the beauty of her garden, and they will feel that it was the ancient garden which was created by the God for Adam and Eve. Okay, did you understand, children? Yeah, what the poet is telling us? The poet first describes that her garden is very beautiful. Okay, her garden is very beautiful, and she compares her garden to a sea of foliage, sea of leaves. The garden is spread all over with the thick leaves, and it is surrounded her bungalow, which makes her bungalow look very beautiful. And she also tells us that she has a different contrast of color. She doesn't have monotonous color like sea. Okay, she has different colors in her garden, and she gives the different colors like light green, dark green, okay, maroon color, gray color, white color. So she tells us the different colors. Okay, her garden is having different colors. She tells us that her garden is filled with different colors, and the tamarinds and the mango clumps. Okay, the tamarinds and mango clumps, they are making her garden look very beautiful with light green color and dark green color. And between the tamarind trees and mango trees, the palm trees are raising like a gray pillars, and which seems like they are like the pillars for the garden. And also the simul trees, they are leaning over the pond in the garden and making the pond look very beautiful. Did you understand, children? And next, what does the poet tells? And the poet tells us that the palm trees, okay, the trees, the different kinds of trees. What are the different kinds of trees? The tamarind trees, mango trees, palm trees, and the simul trees, they are making sounds which sounds like the sound coming out of the trumpet. Okay, a beautiful or the pleasant sound. Now she also tells us that her garden is very beautiful. She loves her garden. It is the loveliest place ever in the world. And she tells that the bamboo trees, the bamboo ranges, the bamboo lines, the bamboos which are grown in a line, which look like ranges, mountains, are the loveliest place in the world. She enjoys, she is enchanting the beauty of the bamboo trees. And next what she tells, and the between the bamboos, okay, between the bamboo tree, when the moon peeps, or when the moon rays, or when the moon rays falls on the lotus, how the lotus will look? The white lotus will look like a silver cup. Okay, she is describing the beautiful, and she is comparing the lotus to a cup, silver cup. Okay, so mainly this poem is based on the comparison. Okay, children, see, first she tells her garden is like the sea. Okay, now she tells us that the garden, the bamboo trees are it is very beautiful, the loveliest place, and the moonlight is like means the lotus. She compares the lotus to a silver cup. Okay, now what the poet is telling, if one sees her garden, if a person looks at her garden, she will, or the person will become very dizzy, or he'll be wondered, he'll be amazed by looking at the beauty of the garden, and he will feel that it was the beautiful place or beautiful garden in the world. And here the poet, in the last line, she tells us that her garden is the primeval garden. Okay, primeval means her garden is the ancient garden which was created by the god for Adam and Eve to live. Okay, do you understand, children? Yes, I hope you have understood. And in the next class, we'll meet with the next unit, children. Thank you, children.